I'm so excited to see all these guys, but for everybody to just honor me all night, it's a little weird. So ever since I heard that I was being inducted into the MND Hall of Fame, I started to think about what I was going to say. And I know it might be a shock for all of you guys that know me, but I didn't actually put the pen to the paper until my flight, which was about 4 hours ago. So I started to write down what I wanted to say. And I started to write down all the people I wanted to thank. And then I started to reflect on how many people were on this list. It just kept going and going and going. And it just made me realize how blessed I've been and how lucky I've been to have all of you guys that are in the room, and even people that aren't even here, to be here. And people that have influenced my life, it just means so much to me. So I'm going to start by saying thank you to everybody that put this together. I want to say thank you to Mark Schenkel, our athletic director. He called me probably in January, and he was like, so you're inducted in the MND Hall of Fame? And I was like, oh, thanks. Yeah, I didn't really know how to respond to that. But then he was like, so when are you free? What day are you free? Is April 18th good? And I'm like, oh, I'll get back to you. I don't know what I'm doing tomorrow. On April 18th, whatever. So I'm sorry if I wasn't the most responsive.
That's right. Turpin took care of it.
I called Turpin. And she was my middle name. Figured it all out. But it's April 18th. I'm here. Everybody's here. So thank you for everything you've done for me throughout my career. I just want to say that MND is such a special place. I couldn't have had a more incredible experience anywhere else. Everyone here is nice, from my classmates, to my teammates, to the administrators, the teachers, just everybody here is awesome, and it's just been so much fun. The academics here was incredible, and it prepared me, more than prepared me, for college. The administrators, Ms. Bodock, who was the principal when I was here, she was awesome. Everyone here knows she was basketball. Like, I don't ever remember her not being there. I was like, what does she have to do anything else? She was awesome. Miss Metcalf, she was actually, when I first got here, she was telling me about when she first got here, and they were saying, oh, this Mel Thomas, she's an incredible athlete, and blah, blah, blah. So then she comes up to me, I'm in the gym, and I must have come from pottery or something, or just my daily life. And she said my skirt was just full of everything, my dress, I'm sure I had my basketball shorts hanging out. And she was like, tuck in your shirt, why do you look so sloppy? And then she was like, what's your name? Or, I don't know, I guess she first got there. I was like, hi, I'm Mel Thomas. And she was like, oh, hi. So master of all trades mission. And then she was actually, the only thing she actually taught me for was multimedia technology.
Oh, I forgot.
So I thought she knew everything about technology, which I still think you do. So anytime I had a problem, my computer's not working, how do I get this Photoshop to load? She, I expect her to answer all of those too. She did. So thank you. Everybody at MND, she's been working off the clock now for, I think, 10 years. So if you want to give her a little bonus.
Yeah.
So thank you, Michetti, and thank you for everybody. Even when I come back to play, when we played at UConn against UC, she was there. When we played against NKU, since I've been at Florida Gulf Coast, all this whole table, all of them have been here. So thank you guys for all the support, even 10 years later. I really appreciate it. So thanks for that. Okay, next. Turpin, she already mentioned this, but she was my manager slash secretary slash alarm clock slash calendar slash personal assistant. Just everything that I needed, she pretty much did. And like she was saying, with me losing my license, I think I'm a hardworking, driven person, but from time to time, I get a little scatterbrained, brain, I lose things occasionally. And she was pretty much the person that fixed everything. Like, why would she know what my ID was when I lived in Florida and I'm going to her wedding in 2 days? I don't know, but she figured it out. She was like, who was the last place? She was like a detective. I found it, so thank you. Okay, next is to, where did he go? He was right there.
He's right there.
Coach Rogers. He wants to come. Are you going to come up with me or are you going to
stay? No, honey, I'm not coming with you.
Okay. Coach Rogers. He already told all of my stories that I was going to tell. But he came here my sophomore year, my freshman year. We actually had a losing season, which is kind of sad to think about. But I think we were 10 and 11. So then I'm going to tell the same story he did, but I feel like I can do a better job.
I think so, too.
So we're all sitting here, this crazy, bald-headed man, running into the gym, so excited. He's running. We're all like, he's our new coach. Oh, my God. So he comes running to the gym with his sign written in bad handwriting. And then he's asking all the questions, like he said. And then he tells us that he has this vision for us, that we're going to go to the Final Four, and he's going to go, we're going to go to Columbus. So we're all looking at him like, yeah, we want 10 games last season. I'm sure that's going to happen. Yeah, I'm sure. But he comes in. This is my motto. It's faith, family, and one big heart. And we don't know this guy. We think he's crazy. He's so animated. He's excited. But then once he was there for a couple days, we started buying into what he said. And, I mean, his vision really made us start to believe that one day it could happen. It took until my senior year for us to finally get there. But each year, we got better and better and better. And I just couldn't thank him enough for what he's done for me and what he's done for all of us. I know we all love him. And it really is like one big family. Your family, Karen, and the girls, and they've just been around, and everybody loves you guys.
Thank you, Mel.
Yeah. Next, I'm going to my teammates. I was watching that video just now, and I was looking at my hair. It was wild. It was out of control, and I'm mad at you guys for not telling me to straighten it. I mean, I was a little pale. You couldn't really help that, but you guys are amazing. These guys have been my best friends, and I don't think that many people can say that their high school teammates are their best friends. And we kind of all have went our separate ways a little bit, but every once in a while, every month or every 6 months or whatever, we all get back in touch, and we've had so much fun, and this has just been the most awesome group of girls I've ever been around. So I love you guys, and thank you for everything that you guys have done. What did you say? How did you phrase how our team was? We were
I don't know. Goofy.
Yeah.
goofy.
Laid back.
That is one way to phrase it. I don't know exactly what we were, but I think laid back is a good way to phrase it. I'm going to go through each one of you guys real quick and just say a little thank you for how great you were to me. Okay, first of all, we got Tanji here. She was a very cheery, happy person, always positive, just fun to be around at all times. And I haven't seen her in a while, and she's here tonight, and it was like she was here yesterday. I love you. It's awesome to see you. Lee. Okay, now Lee, when she first got here, everybody thought she was a weirdo. And then she joins our team, and then we all start to realize that she really was a weirdo. But we were okay with it. We loved her for her weirdness and accepted it. And she was an awesome, awesome player for us, and she really helped us, and I don't know that we would have been able to do what we did without her. So she was pretty awesome, and she came all the way from New York. She works in New York. She's going to be a CEO in a year, but came all the way from New York. What are you doing now?
I audit.
She audits.
Ernst & Young. With Ernst & Young.
Ernst & Young. Yeah. Oh,
it's a pretty big deal.
Yeah. She was always the smart one of our bunch. But we love you, even though you were a weirdo. We accept you now, and I'm so happy you came for this. Next, where's Cassie? Cassie. Now, Cassie, if you guys haven't met Cassie, Cassie is a sweetheart. She is the nicest, most good-hearted, just wholesome person I've ever met in my life. Yeah. Right, look at her. You feel uncomfortable. You know how I felt all night. But, there is a but. When we were in high school, we used to wrestle all the time. And it got pretty vicious. I mean, you know, she weighs like 15 pounds. So, obviously, you know that I could beat her up. But we'd start wrestling. And then I'd have 3 Brandon sisters on. So, 4 against 1. And if you guys don't know her family, they're a little crazy. So, 4 Brandons against me. I didn't really have a shot, so it really wasn't fair. But Cassie went on to NKU. She won a national championship, and I'm so proud of her. But yeah, I love you. Okay, next, Albert. Allie Ross. Now, I'm going to make you stand up.
Why?
When we were in high school, this was her trademark move. Everyone knows what it is. Not sure why, but it was. But Allie has been one of my best friends for, I don't know, forever, since 7th grade. She's always been there for me, always someone I can count on. There's actually a few of these people in this group. I had to do, when I was in grad school 2 years ago, I had to write, it was like a research project I had to do, and I had to interview 20 different universities. So I had to you guys too. Yeah. There's way too many people nodding like, yeah, I do. So it was like, I'm a little bit of a procrastinator, so it was like a week until I had to turn in my final project, and I had to transcribe all of these things that were audio files. So I literally called everyone that I loved, and I was like, please help me, I'm in a family class. So my 2 cousins right here, Albert, Turby, Mish, my mommy, my brother, who else did it for me? It was just way too many. I was like, I have 25, can you please just do one? No, it takes 15 minutes, really 2 hours. But anyway, she was one of those people. She just literally would do anything for me. But she was always the life of the party. If we needed entertainment, we're like, Allie, do something funny. Go ahead, do something funny. She was... No one on our team, like everyone's been saying, no one cared who got the spotlight. We just all wanted to win. That was just our main focus. But Allie was always like, it should be me. I don't know why they're interviewing you. It shouldn't be me. So,
what is true?
Yeah, it was a joke. But one time, I don't really remember who it was, but somebody was up there interviewing me, videoing me, and Allie was in the gym shooting or something, and they're like, is there anybody around that can help us out? And I was like, oh yeah, I have someone that can help. So they call Allie, the video guys, like, hey, Allie Ramos, can you come help? So Allie comes running upstairs, like, hey, you need me to talk to you. Mel said you could hold the light. So Allie did a hell of a job. Best I've ever seen. But she's been one of my best friends in my life, and I love you. Okay, next, JoJo. Okay, JoJo's been one of my best friends since grade school, but for some reason, when we were in high school, we always seemed to get in trouble. And I had the mic, so I'm just going to blame it on you. It was JoJo's fault. Joanna was the reason that we always got in trouble. Well, we definitely had some fun times, and I love you too.
Okay, next,
Michelle. Michelle was the diva of our team. I mean, I've been really, really close to Michelle. I've talked to her, I don't know, weekly, however, I don't know how often we talk, but we talk a lot. But I am glad that I wasn't Coach Rogers when she was playing, because this girl always had some kind of energy, some kind of face. It might have been when you're back in the circle, but she always had some kind of attitude. But she's been a really close friend of mine as well. And I know I keep saying, like, everyone is a close friend of mine, everyone's a close friend of mine, but these are, like, my best friends, and it's funny to say that everybody that played on my team is my best friends, but it's true. So, next, Angie. Some of the stories I was trying to think of weren't quite appropriate, but... Angie and I always pick up right where we left off. She is a very outspoken human being, and I just want to say I'm glad that I'm on her side, because I wouldn't want to be on the other side of that. And you're a great friend of mine as well. Creepy, creepy, creepy. Okay, and then Kim, where's Kim? Kim was Turpin's little mini-me. She showed her the ropes and showed her that someone like me needed some guidance, how to do it, and lead them the way. So thank you for everything you did, and I'm glad you were a part of 2004. Okay, next, my mommy and daddy. Wave. Look at my mom with the princess wave. Yeah. They were...
The queen wave.
She's a queen. My mom is... My mom actually is a sausage queen. I'm just gonna let everyone know. Bachfest downtown. They have a sausage what is it? Contest. And she actually won. She wore sausage links in her hair. And she was the reigning queen until a couple weeks ago when she had to hand over her crown, which is kind of upsetting, but I have her poster. She has a poster in my house with a goat and her meat and sausage meat in my house. So I'm very, very, very proud of her. So. But anyway, my parents have been the best parents I could ever ask for. They have always been there from when I was like 10 years old.
They were there before that too, Mel.
I mean, they've been there the whole time. But I couldn't have asked all career-wise. They were just always there. They were so supportive. I was 10 years old. It was snowing. I was like, rebound for me. I'm sure they were like, no, I don't want to rebound for you. But they did. They were there for everything. They've just been my biggest fans. They've traveled the whole country following me. And honestly, I can't remember any games that they didn't go to until I went to UConn. That was kind of far away. But there was one AU tournament that I think somebody was getting married, and they didn't come. And I twisted my ankle really bad. I couldn't play for like 2 weeks. And then my mom was like, I'll never miss another game. I think that was the only game I literally ever remember them missing before I got to UConn. And they were only there at like 80% of the games. So I went to UConn. So I want to say thank you for being there forever and making me into the wonderful human being that I am. This is not up for the game. You guys are awesome. I love you. And then all the other parents who are here or not here, I just think our whole group was a very, very, very special group of parents. I think our parents were as great of friends as we were. And after all the games, we'd go to the Chicken on the Run. And we would be there for a long time. We'd be like, can we go home yet? I think I've got to go do my homework. And they'd be like, yo, one more beer. So never. So we stayed there for a long time, but it was just so special. After we had practice meeting at 5 o'clock, and at 3 o'clock we'd either go to her house, Allie's house, or my house, or whatever, it doesn't matter. We just had a very, very, very supportive group of parents, and I still love all of you guys today. So if Red is here, thank you for coming in, and Red is not, I still love you too. Then my brother bear, right here. My brother bear.
I can't move my hands.
He's recording, so he can't move. But, he was forced to come to all of my games since he was a child, but I'm sure he loved every second of it. Every one of his vacations was to my AU tournaments, and then when he got to college, all of his spring breaks were to scenic Connecticut. So thank you for coming and supporting me, whether you wanted to or not. I love you. Okay, next. There's Grandpa and Viv. They came, and they have on their MND t-shirts. Because that is 10 years ago. Grandpa has all the scores on the back if you guys are wondering how we did for the season. but they came to every game. They followed me. AAU, starting when I was like 10 years old, AAU to Mount Notre Dame. Italy. They came to Italy. The Virgin Islands, keep going. Basically everywhere I've ever played they've been. They went to all my games at UConn. Everybody at UConn knew them. Like, they made friends with all of our fans, and they used to always ask about them. So I'm just so grateful that you guys were part of the journey, and I love you guys. So thanks for coming out. Okay, next we have the rest of my family. My mom has 10 brothers and sisters, so there's a million of them. But everyone that's here, we got Eileen, Frank, Julia, Mitch, Lara, Darcy, and Kim. Yeah, everybody that's not here. My Aunt Jerry, she is the biggest basketball fan now. And when I was in college, or when I was in high school, she didn't know anything about basketball at all. And then now she became the greatest fan in the history of basketball. She follows high school games. She's like, hey, did you hear how Princeton's doing this year? I'm like, no, I didn't. She's followed every high school game, every college game now. I get emails on a daily basis about every team that's doing. So thank you to her. She couldn't make it, but thank you to her. Who else is here? Ellen and Sassy. They were my AAU teammates' moms, and they kept my mom company on the road. And they got her into trouble. They were like the bad moms club. They used to go out and get in trouble. So thank you guys for coming. I love you guys. Thanks for the current basketball players who are here. It's awesome that you guys are carrying on this legacy, I guess. But this has just been such an awesome, awesome, awesome experience for me. And without everyone that's here, I wouldn't have been able to do what I did. But it didn't really matter what I did. It's what and I'm just so thankful for all of you guys. I love you guys. You guys are my best friends. So thank you for all my teammates, family, administrators, coaches. Am I missing anyone? Everybody that's made this possible. You guys are awesome. Thank you for this honor. It was really just an honor to play with all you guys and get to experience these lifelong friendships with all you guys.